Good day, fellow investors. One of the most important topics when it comes to investing returns over the long term today is, unfortunately, politics. And as an investor, you cannot avoid checking the situation, seeing how that will impact your future investments, your future returns, and at the end, your financial life. Politics is very, very important. But there is so much noise out there in the media when it comes to politics. Everybody is saying a lot of things, and I'm going to discuss a little bit the situation to give you a little bit of color on what's going on, and then I'll give you a solution when it comes to investing, when it comes to what I do, and that might be a really, really good starting point to avoid the noise and focus on the things that matter. Let's start talking investing politics. We have elections, trade wars, sanctions, Brexit, interest rates, a lot of things that can affect or has been affecting the stock market over the last years and will probably affect that in the future. So if we look at elections, there is a lot of risk depending on who will win and when will win the elections, whether will Trump continue over the next 4 years or we'll see a new current in US politics, for example. If we just look at Elizabeth Warren, she is really different than Trump. And if she wins, let's say taxes will probably go up. There will be implications for businesses. We have seen recently how she's saying she will go after the mega mergers that affect how business is done. She will look at them retroactively for 2 decades and ban them going forward. So anti-monopoly legislation, unwinding Facebook's acquisition of WhatsApp and Instagram, along with Google's purchase of YouTube. So this is really, really different, but this is also already going on. Amazon faces widening antitrust scrutiny in Europe, in the US, all over the place. Politics is always busy with what's going on in business. And then it depends on what is the strongest current. Apart from business implications, we also have a potential wealth tax. How are they going to implement the wealth tax? Well, politicians will always find a way. And that's also something that could impact investors. That could be a higher corporate rate that was just lowered, higher dividend taxes, income taxes, wealth taxes. Who knows what they will invent. If the current changes, then it's likely that stocks and investments will also be hit. As it looks like now, Trump will probably win the next election, but if we have a recession then during Trump times and monetary policy free, we will see whether he will win the 2024 election, and then we don't know whether this or the other populism, they are all our populists there, will prevail and how will that impact stock market returns. If you don't believe politics can impact stock markets, please watch a video that I made in August about the Argentinian market that crashed 55% in 1 day when it became likely that the business pro-oriented president candidate will not win and that the leftist, the same case as we have in the United States practically, will win. There was a 55% plunge of the Argentinian stock market. And I don't know who will win, but this is something to keep in mind when it comes to politics and politics impacting investments. Further, if you look at Trump has really been a tailwind for stocks. All his tweets, many tweets, really pushed stocks higher. Congratulations, USA, the new stock market record today. Workers, it will be more and more difficult to retire on stocks to get a yield, to get a dividend, because it's more and more expensive to buy stocks for your retirement. But Trump talks to just one part of the population, and that's also Elizabeth Warren's target, to target those that Trump doesn't talk to, those that don't have a big lump sum portfolio, but those that still have to invest, still have to build. Also, what he has done for corporate America is to lower taxes really from 35% to 21%. So federal corporate tax rate. This really gave a push for stocks. Another push for stocks came as he constantly put pressure on the Fed to give more free money, not to increase interest rates, and the Fed caved in. So we have a weaker dollar, lower interest rates, and with such a tailwind, plus the fiscal stimulus through higher and higher budget deficits, stocks can only go up. And since Trump got elected, stocks are up hugely. If you see the election 2016 November, since then the market is up approximately 50%, a lot of that thanks to Trump and his ways of manipulating and stimulating fiscally and monetarily the market. However, there is something very, very important. You can grow on debt or you can grow on productivity. The US economy is growing on debt. So what you get now, you will have to pay back later. And this is something that Trump doesn't talk about. Let me show you. If you compare the gross domestic product growth to the growth of the federal debt, then you can see that over the last 10 years, the federal debt that you see here, the red line, is much, much steeper, which means the federal debt grows at a much faster pace than the gross domestic product. This means that the economy is actually growing much, much slower than what are the real indications, because without the debt, there would be economic stagnation. And that's a fact that will come biting back in the future. And this future is what you have to think about when it comes to investing. What's my exposure to the dollar? Can I find better risk reward situations, better investments, diversification? Here I'm already talking about the solution, global diversification. Is there something better? And that's what investing is all about. Constantly comparing risks and rewards in line to what is likely to happen over the next 10 years. High debts, we already discussed it in an economic overview video, high debts will lead to currency debasement, which means weaker dollar, and you have to see how you best invest in that scenario. Perhaps stocks will go up, perhaps not. If we have a crisis, perhaps there will be more money printing, monetary policy free, but that's something highly difficult to predict. I don't know who will win the next election. If we go back to 2014, nobody expected Trump to win the election. So that's something very important when it comes to politics. Then there we have trade wars, constant talk about trade wars, bullying each other, delays, not delays, seeing how trade wars impact the market, correcting that position, but still bullying. And it's really uncertain how will this end. So nobody knows. So uncertainty is something you have to implement into your investment analysis and outlooks when it comes to investing. Then we have political decisions. Technology gets political with Huawei that is banned from a few countries. And that's also something you have to watch at when it comes to investing. Please consider subscribing. It means a lot to me. It supports the channel. And please click that notification bell as I do a lot of various videos so that you don't miss out on those videos that are really important for your financial success, always long term. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Further, policy, monetary policy, politics, pushed by politics to help the developed economies of the world save themselves. Interest rates have been negative for a while, over the past 5 years in Switzerland, Sweden, Denmark, European Union, Japan. And this is also a global politic game, considering currencies, risks, real assets. And it is very important to know how to navigate this economic environment. So what do? I have investments that give me natural moats, because if currencies are sacrificed, if I hold something that has a natural value, be it a mine, be it production of electricity, be it, I don't know, fertilizer production. So that's something that will give and constantly give value, and will also probably have pricing power in the future, thus give you inflation protection. Plus, if I can find those assets, because commodities have really been beaten down because everybody's following tech stocks, then I really can find a bargain and a win-win situation for me. Plus, I'm diversified across the globe, so if something bad happens in one country, there are still other countries that can save me, give me diversification from income streams, for currency, from everything. Or if one currency drops like the dollar, a lot of things will be repriced, inflation, that are like commodities sold by the dollar. So when it comes to investing, we don't know who will win, what will happen with trade wars, how will be the geopolitical situation in the next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 10 years. But what we can do is compare the risks on a micro level. Are people going to need, I don't know, fertilizers from Russia in the next 10 years? Highly likely, yes, because Russia's big global demand is globalized for food, therefore also for fertilizers. And you always those value, those things that are, when something is cheap at the lowest cost, it always finds a way to the market. So that's, for example, one way of diversifying. To really, you have the US, you have Russia, if you have both, you are diversified. And then you see, okay, how does this impact my stock from a micro level? And when you compare all those micro possible outcomes, you have a global political risk-reward situation for your portfolio, and that's the only thing you can do. You can take the uncertainty from a macro level, apply it to the micro level, what you own, and then just try to balance those risk and rewards on the actual business, not on the talk. Some businesses in Argentina, they fell down, but the business continues as is. Nothing really changed for the businesses. So that's something very, very important to think about when it comes to investing. The noise, the macro noise that your head is still being bombarded every day from the news, that we also did a little bit in this video. And then you have the micro impact on the real business you own that will give you, okay, also will give you great weight on what is the importance of all those news. Okay, how important is the trade war? Just look at the business that you have been investing in. Just look at Apple sales of iPhones in China, and then you see, okay, this is what's going on, or export imports. And then you have a good perspective on the real risk rewards when it comes to investing. Thank you for watching this stock market news related to politics. I hope that the micro perspective on analyzing political risks on the business you have, not on the stock, will really give you value over the very long term. And then you will be able to structure a portfolio that gives you a margin of safety in the business form and high upside from business returns. That's what I do. If you want to check what I do, check my stock market research platform. I do the research for less than $1 a day for you, so I think it's a bargain. There is a 28-day money-back guarantee, so you can check it for free practically. No risk, high potential upside if you find value in my investment style. Thank you for watching, looking forward to your comments. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.